surgical aspects of the lasers. I guess that it is also challenging because destroying tissues and saving neighboring tissues is a big challenge. And of course, the laser knife or the laser is a very useful tool, but it could be very dangerous if the neighboring tissues are not safe. So it is really a pleasure that we have such experts in Szeged. But as always, I tend to invite colleagues from other places, and I guess it will be a useful morning session. Please interview with the speakers, ask questions, make comments, because it is possible since there are not too many during the sessions. So, Professor Rovó.
So, first of all, I'd like to thank you very much for this Nobel Congress. Unfortunately, the weather is very bad, so we have many here. And this topic in this morning, we will speak about the laser surgery aspect of the otolaryngology. So, me and my colleagues worked in the university, but we have really honorable guests, distinguished guests. They are really experts internationally on this field. The first is Professor Imre Gerlinger, who is the chair of the Finnish University of his department. And the second is a really well-known person in the international field, Dr. Gyöngy Halmos, who is also a Hungarian doctor, but he works now in Groningen, and he's the head of the head and neck oncology lab in the university. So, my personal topic is the treatment of the penile-laryngotracheal lesions by endoscopic CO2, a carbon dioxide laser. So probably you have seen this model many times, so I don't want to speak too much about this. And this is the general blueprint of the light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. You have seen this probably many times, so I don't want to speak too much about it. And this is the general blueprint of the laser device. And you can see there are two mirrors in this device, and there are laser material. And according to this laser material, different wavelength can be achieved. And it is really important in the field of the surgery, because the most the effective part of this laser, when the absorption is the maximum, so you can see very clearly that generally these lasers are frequently used in the surgery, because the tissues contains lots of water. So, but the laser spectrum depends on the laser material, as I mentioned. And in the ENT, the most frequently used laser is this carbon dioxide laser, because we can cut and turbulate on the surface by this device very easily. But as you can see, in the medical field, we can apply many types of lasers. So here we can see again the generation of the generator laser. And we will have a copper and monochromatic parallel photons. And this is the device. This is a really modern device, what we can see here. And this is the device which generates the laser. And we have to speak very briefly about the effects of the laser beam. These are the side effects, I can say, but this is the main effect what we use. And the vaporization of the laser. It has a necrotic zone and a thermal conductivity and repair zone, and this is the normal tissue. Please notice well refers to the international results. To be honest, only very few papers here in this problem, because this is not a success story. And we can clearly see, but unfortunately, the numbers are not the best, that means that the Q rate of the time free analysis is very low, less than 15%, the final Q rate. So this is not an ideal device, seemingly, to this problem. But using a sophisticated Faraday laser, microscopes, manipulators, and electroconvection might help in the long run. I would like to show you some case about where we can use the laser. This is a, and how can we use it? This is a 4-year-old boy, and this is a optic web. This means in between the vocal cord there is a web, a scar formation. This scar is very thick because the scar was tried to be removed by laser 2 times before our intervention. You can see now the cutting of this web and the scar by laser. And we apply the topical mitomycin, which is an inhibitor of the fibroblast proliferation. And we apply a special stent, which was placed in between the surface of the vocal cords for 6 weeks. After this intervention, which was not really comfortable for the young boy, we could achieve the declaration, and you can see the nice space in between the vocal cords. But as you can see, this patient must be trachotomized for a longer period of time. Other important question here in the melite, the problems, the bilateral vocal cord immobility. It has many reasons and many factors. I don't want to speak too much about this, but you can see the main problem that the parallel vocal cord position does not allow enough air for the patient. If you take a look at the regularly used solutions, we can clearly see that now the working force of this surgery is the laser surgery, which gives a more or less adequate airway, but it consists of the more or less resection of the body structure. As you can see, this is the vocal cord, and this is some kind of incision can be seen on the glottic area. This is what we can see here during the surgeries, but compared to the normal airway, we can clearly see that this is not an ideal solution. For example, this is a transverse chordotomy, what you can see here, which generally means a V-shaped resection of the posterior part of the vocal cord by the paralyzer laser. But if you compare it to the normal larynx, even a bilateral application of this method won't provide a really good airway for the patient. This is the open larynx, this is this triangle represents the size and the measures of the transverse cord. duration after some month of the surgery is the poison, so the laryngeal functions are preserved by this method. You can see the peak inspiratory flow parameters in some patients after the first year, so this is a successful treatment. How can the results be improved another way? We can use a more sophisticated laser technology. We have it now. I would like to remind you that at the beginning I spoke about the continuous wave mode of the laser, and this field provides a relatively large necrotization zone and the large thermal damage as well. But we can solve this problem if we use another wave energy delivery. We use this three-pulse mode, which provides that we deliver energy in blocks. So there is a clear relaxation and cooling time for the surrounding tissues. So we can give a larger energy in the same place with a lower heat damage. And this is the ultra-green pulse mode. What we can use, when we use this shape of energy delivery, energy blocks, and this provides a much more relaxation time and practically a much higher energy delivery to the same place. So, this is a modern device what we have now with an upstream pulse mode. So it has an input mode, a high peak over a short duration time of the lasers, and is a large relaxation period. So the lateral thermal speed decreases, and the thermal damage decreases as well. So this is the parameters, this is the really high values what you can see here, and with a very short period of intervals. This is more than 300 watts, it's very, very high energy level, and it will provide a much better result. And we should combine this laser with one of the newest type of manipulators, and you can see the lots of fitting position of the head, that we can achieve a very small spot during the surgery for the laser. So I would like to demonstrate to you what is the difference. This is the 25 watts continuous wave compared to the 250 watts ultra-deep pulse mode, and you can clearly see the difference. The necrotization zone, the thermal zone is much lower, and so the cut is much more clear than with continuous wave. So, how can we use this? This is a 10-year-old girl with anterior commissure connection, what I told you earlier, because I applied this for the same cases, the different methods. This is what I've shown you earlier. This is the membrane in between the vocal cords. This is the surgery. This is the ultra-deep pulse mode. As you can see, very gently and softly we can divide the vocal cords by the lasers. There is no necrotization at all. In this case, we use the mitomycin as well. This is the 5 watts proliferation indicator, as I told you. This is the outcome of the surgery. You can see practically there is no necrotization on the vocal cord. And this is some months later, only a very mild breast tenosis occurred. So there was no need for a long lasting stenting with the tracheostomy. So we can solve this problem without tracheostomy. This is a laryngomalacia, another problem. This is a very young baby, and in generally these babies must be tracheotomized because the laryngeal structure is not strong enough to keep the walls against the bare